sin is exposed by the light of the Word of God. Are you praying with me? Amen. And once we find out, what we find out is what we've been doing in the dark is an abomination unto God. Are y'all gonna pray with me? Amen. We need to understand. And I know we talk about abomination, and all of us, what we think about immediately, we think about homosexuality. That's an abomination. I won't do that. I'm not an abomination. Every sin, all sin, is an abomination to God. You sleeping with somebody's wife, that's an abomination. You lying on somebody on the phone, abomination. You gossiping about somebody, abomination. Come on, somebody. If you look at the Bible, you do the word study, and you will find that everything that is contrary to the will and to the laws of God is an abomination unto God. Are y'all gonna pray with me? So we need to stop picking on gays and homosexuals. We need to stop picking on folks. No, it ain't right. But none of us are completely right in God. All of us have some nasty stuff. Are y'all praying with me? I'm going to leave you alone. I got two more things. I'm going to sit down. First of all, we need to recognize. Then we need to repent. Then we need to reveal. But we also need to relate to our sins. Verse 9 says, we confess our sins. The Lord is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and cleanse us of all unrighteousness. Verse 9 deals with confession. And confession is relating to our sins. It is simply naming your sin to God specifically. Amen. Talk to him about specific. God don't want to talk to you, but he know you sinner. He know.
Yes, sir.
Talk to him specifically. And then agree with God about your sin. Are you praying with me? About the nature of our sin. That's what confession is. Confession ought to be done immediately. Don't wait till you get home. Don't wait till tonight when you pray. As soon as you do it, you know, Lord, I know I wasn't supposed to do that. Lord, I confess this before you. I said that. I shouldn't have said that. I did this. I shouldn't have done this. I had this kind of attitude and I was judgmental. I shouldn't have done that. And I know that you hate that kind of stuff. Lord, I'm confessing. Forgive me of my sin. Are y'all praying? That's what a prayer of confession sounds like. And a truly mature Christian is not one who doesn't sin. A mature Christian is someone who stays in close fellowship with God because they confess immediately.
All right.
Are y'all praying with me? Not only that, not finally. We must rest in the Lord for the forgiveness of our sins. Now I know that most of us as believers, we understand that we are forgiven through the blood of Jesus Christ, but we don't rest on that forgiveness. The Bible says, verse 9, if we confess our sins, he's what? Faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us of all unrighteousness. All of us have sin in our lives. All of us have stuff that we need to deal with. All of us have stuff we need to confess before God. None of us are excluded. Romans 3 and 23 does not say y'all have sinned. It says all have sinned. Are y'all praying with me? But I've got some good news. God made a way for us to have our sins forgiven so that we might be able to deal with our sins. It's in the text. He put it so that we could bring our sins to him, and already with the assurance and security that he is faithful to forgive us of our sins. And he made a place where we can bring our guilt and bring our sins. And exchange our sins and our guilt for his joy and his peace. Jesus offers that peace to us. It's in the blood that was shed on Calvary. And the blood is what Jesus offers us to bring back and to reestablish our peace with God. It's his blood. And the blood is still sufficient to wash your sins away. Not only is it sufficient, but he's faithful. In other words, if you bring your sins and you are in Christ, he has promised that he's going to forgive you of your sins. He's faithful. It's in the text. Verse 9 says, said, he's faithful. He always forgives and he always cleanses. No matter how often you come, he always receives you and he will always clean you. Not only forgive you, but the Bible tells us that he forgets our sins. He doesn't hold it over us so that the next time, you know how we do with our children. We tell our children, all right, I gave you one more chance. If you do that one more time, I already owe you from yesterday. We holding it over. God doesn't hold it over. He doesn't do it like we do in relationships where we have three strikes and you're out. You already got one strike. You're not going to do this to me again. And if you do it again, I'm done with you. But God is like that. He forgets about our sins. He says, as far as the east is from the west, that's how far your sins are being from my remembrance. He forgets our sins. He treats us like we never did anything wrong before. I love that about God. He's faithful and just to forgive us. He will never hold it against us. He will never lord it over us. And not only that, but he promises to do it whoever comes.
Amen.
He said, whosoever will.
Yeah.
If you bring your sins, he doesn't care how long you've been in it. He doesn't care how long you've been doing it. He don't care how many times you tried and you couldn't get out of it. He says, whoever comes.
Yes, sir.
He says, I won't turn you away. He promises to do it. On John chapter 6, verse 37, Jesus says, all that the Father giveth me shall come to me, and him that cometh to me, I will in no wise cast out. Matthew 11, chapter 28, Jesus says, come unto me all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Are you praying with me?
Yeah.
Revelation chapter 22, verse 17 says, and the Spirit and the bride say, come, and let him that heareth say, come, and let him that is athirst come, and whosoever will, let him come. Take the water of life freely. If you're going to deal with your sins, you got to come to me, Jesus says. If you're going to deal with your iniquities, you got to come to me. If you're going to deal with your whole hang-ups and your hindrances, you got to come to me. He says, if you come, I won't reject you. If you come, no matter how loaded down you are, no matter how heavy laden you are, I won't turn you around. If you come, no matter how long you've been in it, he says, I still will forgive you if you come to me. Anybody ever come to him? Anybody ever tried it? Are you praying with me? Yeah. Well, somebody in here saying, no, you don't know my situation. You don't know my story. I got too much stuff. It's too late for me. It's too late. I tried and I tried and I don't believe God will forgive you. Well, you need to know that our God is a God of renewal. He's a God of revival. He's a God of renovation. He's a God of a redo. He's a God of another chance. All you got to do is try him and he will. He'll be faithful and just to forgive you of your sins. He won't just forgive you. The Bible says he'll cleanse you of all unrighteousness. And when I thought about it, I said, you know what? The Lord has given us a wonderful invitation. He said, just keep on going. Don't you quit and don't give up. Just keep coming and bringing your sins. But the blood of Jesus is still sufficient to wash your sins away. It's a wonderful invitation. I'm not going to destroy you, but I'm going to straighten you out and renovate you and make you brand new. I was thinking about this and I thought about something. I was driving by on 24th and Cummings a couple of months ago, and the McDonald's on the corner, and the McDonald's closed down, and they tore the whole thing down, and they started from the ground up, building it all over again, and now it's open for business. And you know what I said? Well, you know that's not what God does with us. He doesn't do us that way. As believers, when we stumble, when we get out of step and we're out of date with his priest, distance. He doesn't tear us down. He said, you need to stay open and I'll fix you. One step at a time. Oh, y'all don't hear me. My wife and I and the family went to St. Louis. And while we were in St. Louis for Wayne's graduation, we went to McDonald's around the corner from the hotel where we were staying. And the sign said, forgive our mess. We are under renovation, but we still open for business to the public. And we went in there and talked to the owner, and the owner said, oh yeah, it's difficult to stay open and stay serving, but still be under renovation. He said, it's hard, but I'd rather stay open and go one step at a time and get it done. And I'm glad that God is like that.
Come today.
Hallelujah. Jesus saves. If you're here, of a local church fellowship, we openly, warmly extend relationship, fellowship with this church. As a member of this church, will you come on your Christian experience? Maybe you publicly confess them, you've been baptized, but you're not a part of a local church fellowship. Will you come? Hallelujah, Jesus saved. If you're here and you need to restore your fellowship, if you have some questions, you're not sure, but you want to come and straighten it out, we invite you to come. We'll work with you. We'll receive you. We'll take you back. You once were a part of this church, but now you're not. We invite you to come. Will you come?